Hey guys, Adam Lobo here from Adam Lobo TV, and in this video, I'll be unboxing this minimalist Nordic watch, the Suunto 9 Peak, and giving you 5 smart ways to fully utilize it, so keep watching. Now, the first thing that stood out to me was obviously the color options that is available. You know me, a guy who loves white colors. So the one which I have is the titanium model, which comes with either birch white or granite blue. Then the other is the stainless steel variant, which comes with all black color and moss gray. Now, as for the unboxing process, first of all, the box comes in white together with the visuals of the watch just next to it. At the back, there's some of the key features available for the watch, such as the wrist heart rate, intelligent battery modes, weather functions, and many more, where you also find the compatibility and the partners as well. Sliding the box cover, first there is the warranty card, where with every purchase comes a 2 years international warranty. Opening the box, you'll immediately find the watch itself. So the watch is wrapped around another white box, where in there there's a USB magnetic charger. Then underneath, there are the manuals and the safety leaflet guide as well. Now before I go further, just a quick overview of Suunto as a brand, just in case you haven't heard of them before, where they were found over 80 years ago by Tuomas Wohlonen, a Finnish adventurer, and since he was the kind of person who was not really satisfied with the current technology then, he invented the liquid field compass with a steadier and more accurate needle, and then transitions to the technology that you see in today, like their diving products and of course right now, this fitness watches as well. Now looking at the watch design, it has a nice rounded face design that looks really sleek. Unlike the older generation of Suuntos that you might know that had a chunkier exterior, it is now ultra thin, and this new minimalist Nordic design is now 30% thinner and 36% lighter than the award-winning Suunto 9 Baro. So because of this, it is Suunto's thinnest and smallest and toughest watch ever. Now the watch has a 1.2 inch LCD display with quite a thick bezels at the side, and the screen glass is built with sapphire crystal glass with titanium grade 5 bezels and a glass fiber that is built for tough conditions. So yes, it's nice to know that even though it has a very premium looking design, but yet it is built to last through every adventure. Now, as mentioned earlier, that the Suunto 9 Peak comes in two different finishes, which is the grade 5 titanium that weighs at 52 grams and also in stainless steel weighing in at 62 grams and is also all weather resistant too. Now this display works very well in bright light conditions, and it also has the automatic backlight intensity adjustment sensor to help with the screen brightness depending on the lighting conditions. Then at the back of the watch face, you'll find the charging points together with the Live Q heart rate monitor that can now also measure your blood oxygen levels. Now as for the strap, it is made of improved silicones with a new metal fastening pin that makes it great for casual and physical activities. And of course, these straps are removable easily with a quick release strap mechanism, so you can feel free to change the watch strap to whatever you like. So the pairing process for the watch is like how any other fitness watches would be. For the Suunto 9 Peak, it also comes with the over-the-air software updates, which was nice compared to the previous generation where updates needed to be done by connecting the watch directly to your PC, and that was not the case with the Suunto 9 Peak. Now, as soon as you turn it on, it'll go into the language selection and then enter your profile settings accordingly. After that, the watch will prompt you to download the Suunto app, which is available for Android and iOS devices. And speaking of the apps, I have to say that this app is one of the best looking overall interface, where it had a nice and a very clean design. Starting from the home screen and how the overall app looks, it was very organized with the progress and the sleep tracking towards the top. Then scrolling down shows the recent workouts that you have done. Moving to the next tab is the training diary, map, connecting to people on social media, and finally the account and general settings as well. So yes, the overall app experience has to be one of the plus features of the watch, and another thing to note is that you do get notifications or messages or even phone calls on the watch, but it's just on a single one way. Now this is of course because of the fact that it is more of a dedicated fitness tracker, and of course to also avoid distractions, where you can set the notifications on which apps that you want to get notified within the app. So the navigation options on the watch are through these three clicky buttons at the watch together with the touchscreen. The button on top is the up navigation button, where you can go through widgets such as the exercise widget. In there, you'll find many exercise lists like running, weight training, kettlebell, cycling, and lots more to choose from. Then there's the navigation widget, where in there you'll find the points of interest, routes, your location, and even compass as well. Next, there is the workout logbook for all of your previous workout stats. Scrolling up goes to the timer widget. And finally, the overall settings widget for you to dive in deeper into the overall settings adjustments. Then the middle button is basically an enter or select button, or at the home screen, it shows the battery percentage and the date depending on the watch face. Then the button from the bottom, or the third button, is for the down navigation button or the home screen, where it goes to the heart rate and the blood oxygen level widget. Next is the stress and recovery state, which is interesting as this feature shows you the body energy level throughout the day. Now this is super useful for me since I do not get enough sleep and my energy levels are always inconsistent. Sometimes I'm tired, sometimes I'm not. So it's nice that the watch indicates on how my body is currently feeling, which most of the time it seems like it is stressed. Given the current situation. We all know why. Then of course you have other widget displays like your daily steps, weekly training insights, training plans, and all other activities. Then you have the altitude measurements and the sleep tracker details. Then as for the touch controls, the swipe gestures brings you to the same widgets for up and down. Then swiping from left to right goes to the back button if you are navigating through the menu, which is the only touch face that I use when it comes to the touch gestures, since the watch does attract fingerprints and smudges easily, and I prefer the tactile clicky feel that the watch button has. Now for the question that you have been waiting for. What are the 5 best ways which you can fully utilize the Suunto 9 Peak at its best? Well, before that, if you guys find this video helpful so far, be sure to give this video a nice big thumbs up and subscribe to Adam Lobo TV if you haven't done so. That would be very much appreciated. Now, firstly, there's the snap to route feature. Now, this basically means that it helps to create a nice clean GPS track, but you have to load in the route beforehand, where this feature is more useful, especially when you are in areas where there's no good GPS coverage, like near tall buildings or basements as well. Now, I find this very sweet because at this point of time here in Malaysia, we are not allowed to go outside to run. So I have been running daily in my residential multi-story parking lot. And this snap to route feature allows me to still give me the best and accurate reading, whether or not the certain areas may not have the best GPS reception, because it will still snap to the route that I've been used to, thus not having any issues with the GPS reading. Secondly, as mentioned, there are many built-in exercise widgets in the watch where you can select up to 80 over sports modes, in which every exercise has its detailed tracking, which is a great way to log into your daily routines and reach your goals better without really losing track, especially with the lockdown affecting our motivation nowadays. And based on all the exercise modes available, I've been using the running, weight training, and the kettlebell workout at this point in time. Then the third would be the blood oxygen level measurement sensors. Now this is a great feature not only to monitor if your blood oxygen levels, but it can also help to determine the acclimation levels, especially if you're into high altitude hiking. But I wonder, where can we go to the great outdoors again? 2030? But keep in mind that the measurements are not as accurate as the pulse oximeter, but it's pretty close to getting to know how the levels are. And the next way to use this is of course during your casual or your formal wear. So now compared to other typical smartwatches that I've seen, or even a fitness tracker, this has to be the best looking watch or even smartwatch or whatever, as long as it is a watch that I've seen for any occasion. I just love how you can change the straps based on your day-to-day activities. And there's a wide choice for you guys to choose from the Suunto's official website, which I'll leave a link down below. And I just love how this Nordic design is ultra thin and is also a watch that is quite female friendly as well, as it is not as bulky as the previous iterations. And what's sweet is that you can also fit it under your jacket or even your hoodie sleeve, making it perfect for any outdoor or even indoor lifestyle activities. And lastly, my favorite or the best ways for you guys to use the Suunto 9 Peak is of course one of my favorite exercises besides weight training, which is running. Now there's this cool virtual ghost runner from the Suunto Plus navigation to practice your pacing when you get bored just running alone. So this feels like a fun game to run, especially nowadays that the lockdown is really demotivating people. So yes, this should be a great start. Now another thing that I would like to bring over here is the battery performance. Now it has fast charging capabilities up to 100% in 1 hour. And speaking of charging, I love how the magnetic charger was very strong and easier to charge compared to some watch chargers where you need to align it exactly to the charging pins. Now in terms of the battery life, you can go up to a total of 170 hours depending on what training mode that you're in. Now there are different training modes or different battery modes. First, there is the performance mode, which can give you up to 24 hours of battery life. And based on the graph seen over here, this performance mode gives you the best GPS accuracy, turning off display timeout, enabling wrist heart rate, and where the brightness, vibration, and Bluetooth is set to normal. Then there's the endurance mode, which gives you up to 50 hours of battery, good GPS accuracy, and this time it reduces the brightness of the watch to 20% where everything else is normal. Then the ultra mode can go up to 120 hours of battery life with okay GPS accuracy, display timeout setting to 10 seconds, brightness set to 10%, and vibration turned off. Then lastly, there is the tour mode, which to me becomes an ordinary watch without using much of the watch features. That gives you up to a massive 170 hours of battery life with low GPS accuracy, data logging to every 1 hour, and everything else is pretty much the same as the ultra mode. Now overall, I'd be honest to say that even though that this is my first Suunto watch, I must say that it is a great watch that has almost all the great features which is needed, especially as a full-fledged fitness tracking watch. Now the build quality is really amazing and I just love the minimalist circular Nordic design, which surely stands out more than other typical fitness trackers or even smartwatches available out right now. Now the accuracy is also very good compared to other typical smartwatches, and with the pandemic lockdown, there's surely been an increase of the number of people doing non-contact sports such as running, walking and indoor cycling alone. So why not go with that peak experience with Suunto? Now as for the watch price here in Malaysia, the exact Suunto 9 Peak that I'm reviewing, the Birch White Titanium, is priced at 3,199 ringgit. And as for the stainless steel variant, it's going for 2,799 ringgit. And you can get your hands on this watch now from online stores like Shopee, Solar Time, and other major online platforms, which I'll leave links down below. And you can also get them in stores after this lockdown is over from AD Time stores here in Malaysia. Now, some may complain about how there are better smartwatches out there with a lower price range. But once again, please keep in mind and please remember that this is not a smartwatch, but an extremely great GPS multi-sport watch. Alright guys, time for a run. Alone. My name is Adam Lobo. Stay safe, keep active, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.